YouTube deleted our last channel. Let's make sure that we get it back up to 10k subscribers and make sure that you guys are subscribing and liking. And it's gonna be an 8-minute video beforehand. You guys could click right through the video to get the video started. Alright, now.
Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes.
Or you can kind of take a walk.
Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. BodyCam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes. Your body cam video will start in 8 minutes. Feel free to skip to 8 minutes.
Late in the night on September 11, 2022, officers from the Jackson Township Police Department made their way to the scene of a serious car accident. Upon arrival, panic fills the air while a bystander relays information to 911. Take note that this vehicle is not only turned towards its side, but is far off to the occupant's right side of the roadway, a fact that we will come back to.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
214-55. Are you okay?
Oh my God!
Were you in the car?
I was in the car,
okay,
yes.
You sit down right here for me, okay? Sit down.
He's
sit
in
down.
The driver's seat. The whole car is so smashed.
How are you feeling? Are you okay?
I'm okay, but...
Did you hit your head?
I don't know what happened. I mean, we saw this car coming at us. We just were at my daughter's house, and my husband all of a sudden just was like, oh my God, and this guy hit us.
Okay.
The airbag went off, yeah. And my husband's in the car.
Okay, they're gonna help him, okay? Just hang tight, okay? I know, just hang tight.
This officer immediately informs another on the seriousness behind the situation.
Yeah, how many got?
Oh my God.
Yeah, he's bad.
All right.
Daughter's up there.
Okay.
And then the mom was in the passenger seat. She's outside.
Okay.
All
right.
Tragedy hits harder when the identity behind the victims are revealed. The accident involved Steph Pappas, a YouTube and TikTok influencer who is well known for her mukbang content. For those who are not familiar, mukbang is a niche of social media entertainment where influencers specialize in eating various different foods, often sharing their opinions about the food itself.
This be bussin'.
Respectfully.
Respectfully.
And is often accompanied by updates in their personal lives.
So my daughter calls me and she's like, hey dad, you wanna go to lunch? I'm like, of course.
Cheers to Christmas.
Should we do a thumbnail?
Steph's loving relationship with her father, John, is obvious when watching her videos.
My dad went in and got the other cookie.
Papa Pappas saved the day.
Yes.
They let me get to keep the cookie.
He cameos often on her channel, sharing food and special moments with his daughter, clearly showing a loving relationship. The criminal actions that led up to this crash would be solely responsible for ending that relationship this night. The car was also occupied with Steph's mother, seen outside of the vehicle, along with their dog Cookie, whose condition is unknown in this moment.
We're gonna have you guys move down this way, okay? Are you hurt?
You think?
Yeah.
Okay, let's start walking down this way.
Sorry, yeah. Come on, let's go down here, okay? Okay, come on. Come on, guys.
Okay. Oh, my God! Let's
move down to this street, okay? Come on, hey, let's go down here, okay?
Is he alive?
I don't know yet. We're gonna, let's do our job.
Oh, my God, they killed him!
Hey, sweetie, please, okay? Come on, please. Okay. We're gonna go down here, guys.
Yes, right now, okay? I'm sorry. I'm talking to the people that are. Okay, thank you. Bye.
Why don't we head in the ambulance here and we'll get you checked out, okay?
Hey, guys, let's go over here and get. Yep. Let's go over here and get checked out, okay?
In this moment, an officer drives his cruiser down the road to meet the man who caused the accident in his totaled red pickup truck.
Oh my God! Please, God! Please, God! I don't need you!
Hi.
I know!
Hey, guys, let's go down here, okay?
Let's get an ambulance here, ma'am, okay?
He was getting out, so I came out.
Okay.
Total. Yeah. And then... Okay. There's another vehicle up there.
Yeah, we have officers and medics over there.
Okay.
I'm okay.
Okay. Okay. Did you witness the accident?
No. We came up on it.
Oh, my God. No, yeah, man.
Hey, let's watch her.
Let's watch her step. I'll help you down here, okay?
We came up on it and didn't even see it because it was in the middle of the road. So we just thought we'd step until you guys got
okay.
here.
Okay.
So I'm going to turn around and go back and...
Okay.
All right.
I'll go shut down there if you'll stay with him.
Yeah.
Point 19.
Yeah. It's me, Mom. Mom, it's me. It's me, Mom. It's me.
Do you have an ID?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes.
Okay, he's... Do I get her?
Where am I going?
What? Yeah, we're gonna go. Be careful. Can you come get her too?
Yeah, she can okay. go to the squad too.
I'm okay.
Are you sure?
Okay, yeah, we'll check on her, alright?
No, I'm on Strasser, about a quarter mile away from Arlington.
Clear. That'll be the male in front of that 7750. Here. Sir, do you have your firearm on you?
No.
Is it in the vehicle?
No.
Okay. All right, just step back here.
Hi, sir.
You mind coming back here with me?
Here it is clear that the truck is sitting on the wrong side of the road, a sign that he crossed into oncoming traffic.
You mind getting off the phone for me?
Yes.
Can't turn them up. Crosser right through the road. You can call it back.
Yes.
Okay, Harry, are you okay? How are you feeling?
My face hurts.
Okay.
Got that cut and everything.
It goes okay. Right there where the picket fence is. Can you explain what happened?
I cannot. Car hit me.
The car hit you? Okay. Which way were you headed?
Towards Arlington.
Okay.
I was gonna make it right at the light, and then my house is right there at Vernal Farms.
Okay. All right. Have you had anything to drink tonight?
No.
Nothing at all? Okay. I'm smelling a little bit of alcohol on you. Alcoholic beverage. Be honest with me. Have you had just one? Have you had anything at all?
No.
Okay. I'm running through a couple tests, okay? Make sure that you're okay, all right? Do you have any problems with your knees, ankles, anything like that?
No.
Okay. Did you hit your head during the accident at all?
Yes.
Okay. Do you wear glasses or contacts?
Glasses.
Okay. Do you have any astigmatisms, anything wrong with your eyes?
Yes.
What's wrong with your eyes?
A astigmatism in both eyes.
You have astigmatism in both eyes?
Yes.
Okay, anything else wrong with them?
That's it.
And I stutter. I've got a speech impediment.
Okay. Do you have, low blood sugar or anything like that?
No.
Nothing at all? Okay. All right. First thing I'm going to have you do, I'm going to test your eyes real quick. Just keep your hands down to your side for me, okay? Just try to look right here at my pen, okay?
All right.
Can you see my pen all right?
Yep.
Okay. All right, what I want you to do, I want you to follow my pen with your eyes only. Do not move your head, okay?
All right.
The officer checks for HGN, or horizontal gaze nystagmus. He is looking to see if the suspect's eyes jerk or shake as they move from side to side.
Follow, hey, right here, you see where I'm pointing?
Yep.
Follow it with your eyes, don't move your head, okay?
All right.
You're not even looking at it. All right, try this again, okay? I need you to follow it with your eyes and don't move your head, okay? Can you do that for me?
Yep.
Okay.
An inability to follow simple instructions, combined with other criteria, can help an officer develop the probable cause to make a drunk driving arrest.
Can you not see it?
Oh, I can see it.
Okay, why aren't you following it then? You're stopping.
I was following.
Okay, just one more time, okay? Are you okay?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
All right. Why don't you go ahead and face me real quick, okay? What I'm gonna have you do, hands down to your side.
Can I actually pull?
Yeah, pull up your pants, you're fine. Actually, what I'm gonna do, stand right there on that yellow line.
All right.
Face this way, okay? Now, whichever foot you like, or we'll take your right foot first, okay? What we're gonna do is a walk and turn, all right?
All right.
Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay, can you see me okay?
Yes.
All right, I want you to take your right foot, place it on the yellow line. Your right foot, okay. Now take your left foot, place it in front of your right. Heel to toe. I want you to stand like that, hands down to your side, while I instruct you on this test, okay?
All right.
What I'm gonna have you do, is during this test, you're gonna stay in that position, don't move until I tell you to begin. You're gonna take 9 heel to toe steps in a straight line on this yellow line.
All
right. All steps must be heel to toe. Do not stop once you begin. I'm gonna demonstrate this for you, okay?
Hey. Tell them to get back.
Hey guys, go back to your house, please. Thank you. Sorry.
Yeah, we're trying to save you from something you don't want to see. So.
Yeah.
Oh. I'll tell you what, I'm going to give you a business card here. If you have anything on your camera that shows the accident or whatever, a later day, just give me a call.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, continue on 9, and then the test will end, okay? Do you understand that?
Yes.
Do you have any questions about that?
For reasons we cannot hear or determine, the officers speak to each other and decide to take the sobriety test further down the road.
Back there? All right, come back here, sir. I want to make sure you're on a flat plane here, all right? All right, here we go. That's a little more flat for you, all right? Okay. Same thing, you want me to instruct you again on this?
6 steps up.
Nope, here. Go, I'm gonna instruct you again. Your right foot, place it on the yellow line. Your left foot in front of there. Stay in that position, okay? Hold on, whoa, hold on, stop. I'm gonna tell you how to do this, okay?
The officer runs through the instructions again, ordering him to take 9 heel-to-toe steps in one direction, turn around, then do another 9 heel-to-toe steps towards the opposite direction.
Hey, do you understand that?
Yes.
Do you have any questions on that? All right, go ahead and begin. Okay, next test I may have you do, stand over there for me. Face me again. Hands out of your pockets, hands down to your side. Feet together. What I'm going to have you do? Do you have any ankle problems, hip problems, knee problems, anything like that?
No.
Okay.
I've worked the last 40 hours in 3 days.
Okay. What I'm going to have you do, when I tell you to, whichever foot you want, I'm going to have you lift it off the ground 6 inches, okay? You're going to lift it off the ground 6 inches. You're going to point your toe while looking at your toe, hands down to your side. You're going to count out loud, 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, 1,005, just like I am. You're going to do this until I tell you to stop. Do you understand that?
Correct.
I understand. Any questions on that?
Yes, sir.
You do have questions?
No
questions?
I do not.
Okay, go ahead and begin.
1, 2, 3.
Look down at your toe.
4, 5, 6, 7.
Continue.
One, two, three. 1, 2, 3.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna have you turn around, put your hands behind your back. Put your palms together. Palms together. There you go. You need to be placed under arrest for suspicion of operating vehicle while impaired, okay?
All
right. All right, I'm gonna make sure these are spaced okay.
Yep.
And then I'm gonna...
You double lock them, okay? Justin, is that right?
Jake.
Sorry. And your last name?
Muter.
Jake, are you having any medical issues right now? I understand your face hurts, but is anything else hurting right now?
Just my face and my right down in
your ankle?
Yep.
Okay, I'm gonna have you go have a seat in the car real quick, okay?
I respect
that's all right, here. I'm just gonna have you lean up against the car.
Can I just put this down in my...
I'm just gonna set it on top of the car and then I'll hand it to you in just a minute, okay? I'm just gonna put it right here, okay? And you can just lean with your back up against the car. And there's no firearm in your car? Okay, and you don't have any weapons on you? Okay.
The officer searches Jacob and finds his phone, wallet, cigarettes, and cash.
Here's the cash.
There we go.
How much cash do we have here, do we think?
Probably, I just got off work, probably $400, if that.
Okay, where are you working?
I'm the manager of the basement.
Okay.
We decided to search the basement on Google Maps near the crash site. We found it to be a small sports bar chain in the area. The closest location to the crash is roughly a 5-mile drive away, indicating this as the distance the suspect probably drove before he caused this crash.
All right, so I'm going to just keep this right in front of you, okay?
All right.
You said $400? Is that what you said?
Between $300 and $400.
Okay, all right. So I'm going to count this in front of you. Right. I've got 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, and 20. So 120 here.
The rest is in the truck.
It's in the truck. Okay, all right. So this is 120, though. I'm going to put it right back in your pocket.
Right.
I don't want it. I want it in your pocket.
You're fine, brother.
All right, so because you are under arrest, you ever watch cop shows? Yeah. You know, Miranda rights. I got to read them to you. Just so you know, you have the right to remain silent. You understand those rights?
Yeah. Okay. Correct. Can I answer? It's my dad.
If you're okay with me answering and then I'll just talk with him real quick, and I'll let him know you're okay, all right? What's your dad's name?
Larry.
The suspect gets to hear from his dad in the moments after the crash, something Steph would never again be able to do.
Hey.
Hi, this is Officer Ains with the Jackson Police.
Yes, sir.
Hi, I'm here with your son. He wanted me to let you know that he's okay. At this point, he is placed under arrest, okay? He's just for suspicion of OVI. There was an accident here, but he is okay.
All right, where is he at? I'm on Charleston now.
You're not going to be able to get to him because we have the road shut down. The accident was not a good accident, so we have the entire road shut down from Arlington to Wales.
All right, did somebody hit him?
I don't know yet. It's still under investigation. All I know right now is that I'm here with your son, and he's okay. But he's going to be coming with us to the station, and then we'll see where it goes from there.
Somebody going to call me and let me know?
Absolutely. 100%. We'll let you. We'll make sure that happens, okay?
Okay, as long as he's okay, though.
Yep, yeah, he's okay physically. He's got some bumps and bruises, and his truck is totaled, but he is okay. I mean, he's walking around okay.
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 All right, sir. I appreciate it.
Yep,
thank
of course.
You.
Yep, thank you. Bye.
All right, come on back here for me, okay?
Yes, sir.
I have a seat in my car.
After a clearly failed sobriety test, officers bring the suspect, Jacob Lee Meuter, to the station for further drug testing. It is imperative that they go through this process quickly to ensure accuracy in their test.
Would I be allowed to smoke a cigarette before I go on there? Not before, but I can get the cigarette after.
While he is at the station, officers on scene gather photo evidence of the accident, showing the full devastation caused by Jacob.
Can you turn around for me?
I'm not going to be combative.
Huh?
I said I'm not going to be combative.
Oh, I don't think you will. You've been cooperative with me, man. I appreciate that.
But have a seat over there for me.
Officers begin making small talk with Jacob before they gather samples for the blood alcohol test. This is likely a tactic used by police to create feigned camaraderie in hopes that he will be more compliant to the test itself, allowing officers to secure evidence.
Watch the Browns play today?
What?
Watch the Browns play today?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. Was it a rough game? Good game?
It was decent. Towards the end, I thought they were going to lose.
Yeah, right?
If they wouldn't have hit the field goal, we would have all been screwed.
Yeah. How'd Baker play?
In the beginning, all right, decent. Mm-hmm. Then in the end, he wanted to show off.
All right, man.
Oh.
We're sore, so bear with me, okay? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna read this to you, okay?
Alright.
The officer is required to read legal text before asking Jacob if he is willing to subject himself to a blood alcohol test. In short, the officer informs him that if he refuses to take the test, he will face immediate consequences, including getting his license suspended, paying fines, and potential jail time.
Make sense? Yes. Do you understand that?
Correct.
Okay. So, I guess the question is, are you willing to take a chemical test for me?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're doing the test.
Yeah. I gotta do some paperwork, but then we'll probably have you call your dad.
Yeah. I talked to him. When I talked to him, I told him we'd give him a call when you're ready to go home. Okay.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you.
Let's go back here and we'll give her a shot. All right.
We don't need a whole lot. Just about 30 milliliters. Is the other car all right?
I only talked with you.
While one officer leads Jacob to a private area to supervise the collection of the urine sample, Jacob's phone goes off. An officer takes it upon himself to pick it up.
Hello, this is Officer Ames with the Jackson Police.
Yes, I was trying to reach Jake.
Yes, Jake asked me to answer the phone. He's just using the restroom right now. But he did. He asked me to answer the phone and tell you that he's okay. He's got some bumps and bruises. He's gotten a little accident. But he is okay, and his dad's going to be picking him up in just a little bit.
Okay, yeah, this is his boss.
Oh, okay. Yep, so he just...
Could you tell me what happened, or...?
Well, there's still an investigation going into that. It was just a car accident. His truck's probably totaled, but he just has a couple bumps and bruises on him. He's walking around okay.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you.
Alright, can I just rest in the table
now? Yeah, you're good, man.
Alright.
Alright, come back in here.
I will never, ever be combative with you guys.
Yeah, we'll just go over here, okay? As soon as he finishes up with that, he'll grab your bag with your phone in it. Then you can give your dad a call. I don't know, 25 minutes worth of paperwork, that's all. And then we'll get you out of here, you can go home.
At the time of the accident, were you distracted by anything? Like changing the radio,
my phone went off.
Your phone went off? Okay. And was your seatbelt on? Do you know?
It was not on?
Okay.
It was not.
Okie dokie. And I think it was side and front airbags.
Yep. It was definitely side and front.
Okay, bye.
Officers returned Jacob's belongings and allowed him to make a call for a ride that night. They exchanged some final words with Jacob before his release.
My roommate's coming to get me.
Is she valid and sober?
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Is the other vehicle okay?
Like I said, I've only talked with you, so I don't know what's going on with the other car.
I appreciate you guys being so cool.
You know, everybody makes mistakes.
Here's your ID, sir. You have all your property with you?
Yep. And your cash is still in your pocket, right?
Yep, and then the rest of the cash in the truck.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't check the truck out.
Yeah.
Anything.
Oops. That's fine.
Okay. All right. So we'll go around this corner. I'm going to turn right.
turn the other right. There we go. After we get the results from the urine test, we'll give you a call. We'll let you know if it's over the limit. We'll give you a call and let you know what the next steps are, okay? Do you have any questions for me right now?
I do not.
Okay, take care, okay?
Stay.
Okay.
Immediately after the incident, the internet caught wind that Steph Pappas' father, John, was involved in the crash. The hasty publicity behind his death prompted Steph to make a video response on her channel, where she addressed the situation just 2 days after the accident. Jacob's court records indicate he faced numerous unrelated traffic infringements in the years prior to this incident. He was caught speeding on multiple occasions, disobeying traffic lights, driving under suspension, and driving without a seatbelt multiple times. The most devastating previous charge, dangerously overtaking traffic while driving on the opposite side of the road. Our records indicate he faced no prior felony charges. It's here that we should highlight the resting locations of both vehicles. The lifted multi-ton pickup truck is seen resting well past the center of the road, while the victims of the crash are well off the right side. The vehicles were also nearly 300 yards away from each other after they stopped. These factors, outside of Jacob's obviously failed sobriety test, suggest he was drunk, speeding, and well into the opposite side of the road, facing oncoming traffic. The heroic actions of Steph Pappas' dad, swerving to the right in his last moments, very likely spared the front seat passenger as well, Steph's mom. Unfortunately, it would be later discovered that their dog, Cookie, was also in the car at the time of the crash and did not survive the accident. On November 21, 2022, over a month after the incident, a warrant was issued for Jacob's arrest that was likely triggered by the results of his urine test coming back. The following day, he was apprehended.
The other driver was 3 times over the legal alcohol limit and going almost 90 miles per hour in the wrong lane on the road.
He pled not guilty to all 8 charges he faced, which included 1 count of aggravated vehicular homicide as a second degree felony, 1 count of aggravated vehicular homicide as a third degree felony, 1 count of aggravated vehicular assault as a third degree felony, 1 count of improperly handling firearms in a motor vehicle as a fifth degree felony, 1 count of OVI due to alcohol as a first degree misdemeanor, 1 count of OVI due to amphetamines as a first degree misdemeanor, 1 count of wanton disregard for safety as a minor misdemeanor, and 1 count of violating speed limits as a minor misdemeanor. On December 5th, 13 days later, he was released on a $250,000 bail. In Ohio, defendants are allowed to pay 10% of a bond in cash to be released. A relative to Jacob provided $25,000 to make that happen. Jacob's defense team attempted to bar evidence from being used in court, the details of which are not revealed in court dockets. Regardless, that effort would prove fruitless, as the motion would be denied in February of 2023. On March 31st, it appears that Jacob took a plea deal. His charges for aggravated vehicular homicide were combined. For that, he was sentenced 7 years in prison, which he would serve consecutively with a sentence of 3 years for aggravated vehicular assault. His remaining sentences would be charged concurrently, which included 1 year for his improper handling of firearms and 30 days for each of his operating a vehicle under the influence charges. Ultimately, he is to serve 10 years in prison with 71 days of jail credit. He also has to pay over $500 in fines. His license has also been suspended for the remainder of his life. He is currently being held at the Lorain Correctional Institution and is expected to be eligible for and released on parole in February of 2033 when he is 37 years old. In the description below, you'll find links for organizations you can donate to and help fight against and prevent drunk drivers in the future.
YouTube deleted our last channel. Let's make sure that we get it back up to 10k subscribers and make sure that you guys are subscribing and liking. And it's gonna be an 8-minute video beforehand. You guys could click right through the video to get the video started. All right, now
video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments. Video now completed. This will be a 15-minute recap time. You can click on our next video, or we can walk and have a short recap into the comments.
Video has been completed. You can stay for the remaining of the time and take a walk with us. Video has been completed. video has been completed. You can stay for the remainder of the time and take a walk with us. Video has been completed. Video has been completed. You can stay for the remainder of the time and take a walk with us. Video has been completed. Video has been completed. You can stay for the remainder of the time and take a walk with us. Video has been completed. Video has been completed. You can stay for the remainder of the time and take a walk with us. Video has been completed.